Hello everyone, welcome to new IAS daily current affairs program. Today is 13th March 2019 and the current affairs topic we'll be dealing today are Enforcement Directorate, Solar Parks and Ultra Mega Solar Power Projects, United Nations Environment Assembly, Black Box, Takrani Jatra Festival. For the map session we'll be dealing with Sea of Galilee and last we have PQRS. So, coming to the very first topic, that is about Enforcement Directorate. This was in news because the officers of Enforcement Directorate interrogated a man who is an alleged middleman in the 3600 crore deal for the 12 Agusta Westland helicopters. So, this Enforcement Directorate, it is a law enforcement agency and economic intelligence agency which is responsible for enforcing the economic laws in the country and fighting for the economic crime in India. So, this Directorate of Enforcement is a specialized financial investigation agency under the Department of Revenue, which is under the Ministry of Finance. So, Enforcement Directorate is under the Ministry of Finance. And this is headquartered in New Delhi. This Enforcement Directorate, it enforces mainly two laws, which is FEMA and PMLA. So, FEMA stands for Foreign Exchange Management Act 1999. So, this is a civil law where the officers are empowered to conduct investigations into suspected contraventions of the foreign exchange laws and regulation, and they can impose penalties on those who are adjudged to have contravened the law. Next one is PMLA. PMLA stands for Prevention of Money Laundering Act 2002. So, this is a criminal law with the officers are empowered to conduct investigations to trace the assets derived out of the proceeds of crime. So, they can confiscate those properties and those assets and properties, and they can arrest and prosecute the offenders who are found to be involved in the money laundering cases. So, the Enforcement of Directorate, they enforces FEMA and PMLA. Alright, moving on to the next topic, it is about solar parks and ultra mega solar power project. So, this was in news because the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy has issued a memorandum proposing the modifications to the guidelines issued for the development of this solar parks and ultra mega solar park. So, there is a slight change in the modification of guidelines for the scheme. So, a new mode, which is known as mode 7, is being introduced for the development of renewable energy parks. Mode 7 is being introduced for the development of renewable energy parks to address the most critical elements such as land and power evacuation infrastructure for the solar parks. Alright, under this mode 7, SECI, which stands for Solar Energy Corporation of India. So, this SECI will make both government and private land available for bidding. And no fund from the central finance assistance would be used for the procurement of land. Please do remember this point. No fund from the central finance assistance would be used for procuring this land. Now, talking about the details of this scheme. So, this development of solar park and ultra mega solar power project, it was proposed to set up at least 25 solar park and ultra mega solar power projects, which targets over 20,000 megawatt of solar power of installed capacity within a span of 5 years, starting from the financial year 2014-15. So, this scheme has been rolled out by the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy. Alright, so this is a scheme for solar energy and it comes under the Ministry of New and Renewable Energy. Now, SECI, as I told before, Solar Energy Corporation of India has been entrusted with the responsibility of administering this scheme. SECI will be administering the scheme and the scheme envisages supporting the states in setting up solar parks at various locations in the country with a view to create required infrastructure for setting up the solar power projects. And the solar parks are envisaged to be developed in 4 modes, and the solar parks will be developed in collaboration with the state government and their agencies. So the choice of implementing agency for developing and maintaining the park is left to the state government. State government can choose their implementing agency. So central government, with the collaboration of state government and their agencies, will be developing the solar park, and India has 34 solar parks operating in 21 states with a total capacity of 20,000 megawatt. Alright, now that's about the topic. Moving to the next, and it is about United Nations Environment Assembly. This was news because the 4th UN Environment Assembly, the top annual forum on the planet's environmental crisis, opened in Nairobi, right? So it is the 4th UN Environment Assembly, and this assembly, it focuses on the theme innovative solutions for environmental challenges and sustainable consumption and production. This is the theme. So the UN wants individual countries to sign up to significantly reduce plastic production, including a phasing out of single-use plastics by 2030, a goal inspired by the 2015 Paris Agreement on voluntary reduction of carbon emission. So this was the major focus of the UN Environment Assembly. So this UN Environment Assembly is the world's highest level decision-making body on the environment. And this was created in June 2012. When the world leaders called for UN environment to be strengthened and upgraded during the United Nations Conference on Sustainable Development, also referred as Rio+20. So this was in June 2012, that is 20 years after the 1992 Rio Earth Summit. So as it is 20 years after Rio Earth Summit, it is also known as Rio+20. And this addresses the critical environmental challenges facing the world today. And they meet biannually to set the priorities for the global environmental policies and to develop an international environmental law. Alright, and this assembly provides leadership and they catalyzes the intergovernmental action on the environment. So this assembly is the governing body of the UNEP, United Nations Environment Program. Next is about black box. So a black box was found among the wreckage of the doomed Ethiopian Airlines plane. This black box, it is an electronic recording device. It is placed in the aircraft for the purpose of facilitating the investigation of aviation accidents and incidents. They are actually painted a loud and vibrant color. It is known as international orange. So it is painted as orange color. So the purpose behind this is to make them highly visible in the event of an accident, since there can be lot of debris. So it is orange in color, not as the name says. It is black body and this is orange in color, and it has got two components. They are flight data recorder. First one is that, and this flight data recorder tracks the information about the plane itself, like its direction and speed. And this is required to monitor a minimum of 88 different stats every second, right? And every flight data recorder contains a tool which is known as underwater location beacon, which makes it possible for investigators to find if a plane crashes into a body of water. So this is underwater location beacon. It helps the investigators to find if the plane crashes into a body of water. Next component is cockpit voice recorder. So this recorder, it records the audio of the crew's conversations, then radio emissions, engine sounds and alarm noises. The information is stored on a memory chip inside a small portion of the device called the crash survivable memory unit. They typically hold 25 hours worth of flight data, like the airspeed and altitude. Alright, so next topic, it is about Takrani Jatra Festival. So this is a festival from Odisha. It is a biennial Takurani Jatra festival in the Odisha's Berhampur, right? So it is from the state of Odisha, and this festival is of the deity of goddess of Buddhi Takurani. That's why the name Takurani Jatra festival. And this festival is related to a weaving community of Odisha. They are known as Dera, right? So this festival is related to a weaving community. That's it. That all these points will be enough for your prelims. And moving to map aided program, today we'll be seeing Sea of Galilee. So where is the Sea of Galilee located? It is the largest freshwater lake in Israel, and here you can see in the map. So this lake is fed partly by underground springs, although like its main source is Jordan River, which flows through it from north to south. So this sea is known by different names, and in Israel it is known as Kinneret. Alright, many other names are also there for the Sea of Galilee. And talking about the geographical location, Sea of Galilee is situated in northeast of Israel between Golan Heights and the Galilee Range in the Jordan Rift Valley. And this valley is caused by the separation of African and Arabian plates. So this is located in northwest of Israel between the Golan Heights and the Galilee region. Okay, so this is a freshwater lake, actually the largest freshwater lake in Israel. That's about Sea of Galilee. Now we will move to PQRS. The question for today is, among the following, who are eligible to benefit from the Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act? A. Adult members of only the scheduled caste and scheduled tribe households. Option B is adult members of below poverty line households. C is adult members of households of all backward communities. And D, it is adult members of any household. These are the four options. I hope you know the answer. This is a simple question. So, talking about MGNREGA, so this comes under an act, that is National Rural Employment Guarantee Act 2005, which is later renamed as Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act, or MGNREGA. So, this is an Indian labor law and a social security measure that aims to guarantee right to work. Alright, so MGNREGA guarantees 100 days of wage employment in a financial year to a rural household whose adult member volunteered to do unskilled manual work. This provides for a minimum of 100 days of wage employment in a financial year, and this the employment will be to every household whose adult members volunteered to do the unskilled manual work. So it is for every members, right? So the correct option for the question is D, that is adult member of any household. There is no such criteria like only for SCST or the backward communities or for the below poverty line community, nothing like that. It is for adult members of any household. So the right option is D. I hope you are clear with the answer. So that's it for today. You can download the daily current affairs material from the link below. Thank you for watching.